يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهدي ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. Welcome you all, brothers and sisters, to this reminder. And today I would like to touch on a verse from the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu idha nudiya lis-salati min yawm al-jum'ah fas'au ila dhikrillahi wa dharul bay' dhalikum khayrun lakum in kuntum ta'lamun. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us of a very important obligation for us as Muslims. He begins by saying, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O you who believe, إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ, when the call of prayer is made on Friday, فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, then rush to the reminder or the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ, and abandon business, ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ, that is good for you if at all you knew. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is encouraging us as believers that on Friday, when the call to prayer is made, then we should rush to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to leave any forms of transactions and businesses. And he terms that as what is better for us if at all we knew not. So this verse, it contains a lot of fiqh issues as well as instructions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So some of the instructions is that Allah has mentioned the Friday prayer in the Quran. So the Friday prayer that we pray is mentioned in the Quran, because that's what Allah is saying, إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ, that when the call of prayer is made on a Friday. So our Friday worship is mentioned inside the Quran, and this verse is the one that is talking about the Friday prayer. So it's not something for people to take it lightly, because Allah has said in the Quran, encouraging you as a believer, that on a Friday, leave everything away and just concentrate on the Friday prayer. فَاسْعَوْا إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ. Yeah. So the other thing that Allah has mentioned in this verse is that the call for prayer, إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ. So from the time of the call to prayer on a Friday until the time when the prayers are finished, it is the time when it is not recommended for people to engage in businesses or in any other thing apart from the Friday prayer itself. So that is an opportunity for you to prepare yourself for the prayers, to go to the mosque in appropriate time, to be able to do all the pre-requirements for the prayers, such as the recitation of the Surah Al-Kahf, and all that is required for you. Now, on a Friday as well, what this brings to us is we have the obligations of a Friday, that on a Friday, then an individual needs to prepare themselves. And part of that preparation is to take a full shower before going for prayers. And this is supported by the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which indicates that ghuslu yawm al-jum'ati wajibun, taking a shower on Friday is an obligatory. And if there is any a day which a Muslim preserve it for making sure that their personal hygiene is at high standard, that should be on a Friday. And this is according to the many hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of which I have just mentioned. So on a Friday, an individual should take a full bath and from head to toe, just as the ghusl al-janaba. That means each and every part of your body should be touched by water. And after that, then it is also recommended on a Friday to put on your best cloth. If you didn't have any other clothes apart from two clothes, then one of them you should preserve it only to be worn on a Friday. This is according to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as well as for men to be able to put some perfume on themselves so that they smell nice. Once you have done this, then you are ready to go and attend your Friday prayers. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentions about the various rewards that people would get depending on the time that they get to their place of prayer. In that, for the earlier hour you go, you are able to give in charity the equivalent of a camel, then a cow, then a sheep, then a goat. And if you get to the Friday prayer at the time when the imam is about to begin the khutbah, then at that time you've only given in charity an example of an egg. So this encourages us that on a Friday we should be able to give ourselves enough time so that we can be able to get to the mosque or the place where we'll be praying as early as possible. The earlier you get there, the better for you, because it means you are giving much in charity. And don't forget that when you go to the place of prayer, then there will be angels who will be writing the names of those who have attended the Friday prayer until when the imam stands to begin the khutbah. Then at that time, the angels, they close their books. So if you come, if you are amongst the people who normally do want to come to the mosque when the imam has begun the khutbah, then I'm really sorry, because you are forfeiting yourself from a lot of rewards. I'll be writing the names of those who have attended the Friday prayer until when the imam stands to begin the khutbah. Then at that time, the angels, they close their books. So if you come, if you are amongst the people who normally do want to come to the mosque when the imam has begun the khutbah, then I'm really sorry, because you are forfeiting yourself from a lot of rewards.